I'm looking forward to speaking a little bit about the history.
Amazing. And what history you've had. I mean, absolutely incredible. I mean, I know we can go way back and we can start at the beginning, like I always do with everybody. But I want to get straight into the Sly and the Family Stone stuff. Start off with that. How did that happen, Greg? What happened there?
Well, the short story is I started playing when I was 14 years old. I loved the drums as from when I was a little kid. But anyway, I started playing when I was 14. And we started the group in December of 1966, which I was 17 and a half. So things moved along quickly in those days. And, you know, I was at the right place, right time. San Francisco was just a melting pot of energy and people and, you know, all kinds of different musics, people from all over the world. So Freddie and I, Sly's brother, had a group called the Stone Souls, and which I had met Freddie about a year and a half after I started playing. And we started the Stone Souls. And then Sly had a radio show back then. He was a DJ. He had a radio show. Very bigger than life personality on the radio, which back then, you know, radio and TV were different animals in the way that, you know, there was no internet. And there was no hundreds of TV cable stations and movies and all that stuff that, you know, I mean, there was like a couple networks, and, you know, so when something appeared on it, it's like a lot of people seen it. It was, you know, that was the focal point. It was a focal point then, which, as you know, is kind of like dispersed nowadays. So many things, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
So anyway, we had the, again, the short story is, you know, we went from the group we had to Sly and Family Stone. Started one day, all met each other. And I told the story so many times, I don't know if I should go long or go short. You know,
go long. Let's get it all.
All right. Yeah. So, I mean, actually, I went to show up one day for rehearsal with Freddie and I's group, the Stone Souls, and lo and behold, the Sly had arranged, you know, I show up for rehearsal and I go, where's everybody? And Sly and Freddie said, you know, we can just put in a group together today. I go, okay. You know, they were just, you know, they had put kind of like talked about this, and Sly had invited everybody over that evening. So we all met for the first time, and it was amazing. I mean, we all, you know, we didn't even play. We just talked about what we were going to do. And it was kind of at that point in time, it was unusual to have females in the group and, you know, to have in black and white. I mean, it was like, it was a time of a lot of racial, you know, issues going on in this country. And so it was like, but it seemed very natural and very comfortable to do this. And we all were kind of like, this is going to be interesting. You know, so we started rehearsing the next day, and it was just amazing. I mean, from note one, it was like, yes, this is going to be special. This is unusual.